Hello guys, welcome back again to the number one YouTube channel for your online earning tricks and tutorials. First of all, I want to say a big thank you for hitting the 10k subscriber mark. I want to say thank you to all my subscribers, those people who even view my content. I'm so much grateful. I couldn't have done this one without you guys, and also thank God for enabling me to meet you guys online. So thank you so much and wish you more blessings. Now, today's video, as usual, I want to review another proxy site called sx.org, and I want to connect their proxies on a Duo Plus crowd phone and check the IP quality there before even going through their various packages and what they offer. But what I can say for now is that they offer mobile proxies, residential proxies, and corporate proxies or data center proxies. But for now, I want us to check the quality of this IP while connected to a crowd phone. And today I'm going to use Duo Plus crowd phone. I had connected another IP from sx.org and the performance was great. That's why I even decided to do this video. Now, I have an active IP here, this one. So I want us to copy the IP and port, then go to my crowd plus here, change the IP, then go to custom under SOX 5. First of all, you remove these parameters so that we won't put a nuance for purpose of this review. Remember, I used to do proxy testing using undetected browsers, but today I want to do a bit different. I want to test it using a crowd phone. So I put, you can see username and IP port, which is IP port. Now let's go to username and password. So this is the username. Username and then password. Password is this one. You paste it here like that. Then always check the IP connection location, whether the IP is online or offline, before even proceeding to do any other stuff. Even in undetected browsers, always check the connection status. So many cloud phones and undetected browsers offer this feature. Then once you're done, just click save. Remember, for you to use a Duo Plus, to set up a proxy on Duo Plus, you have to use a SOX 5 proxy which has a username and password. That's very important. And if you don't know how Duo Plus works, I did a review for them on my YouTube channel. Go through my previous video, search for Duo Plus, and you're going to find the review so that you can understand how it works. So that's how you set up a proxy on Duo Plus crowd phone. And that's how you set up, specifically sx.org proxies on Duo Plus crowd phone. But now, when you set it up now, just click connect. Click connect now so that you can open the crowd phone. So this is the crowd phone, yeah, right here. Now let's say, you see it's opening very well. Now let's check the IP quality on hua.net. So let me search here. Hua.net. Let's see whether the IP is good enough and the kind of ISP we are getting here. So from this number here, I can see this is a T-Mobile proxy. T-Mobile is one of the best in doing surveys. Perfect. Let's check. Let it open. So you can see on a crowd phone, we're even getting a DNS for USA. This is very important. An MP which gives you a USA, a DNS corresponding to the IP location is the best. For example, this one you can see the IP is in USA and our DNS is in USA. This is very important. Also, the advantage of using, and the this guys is 100%. So this one, this is a very perfect IP, this one. Yeah, for example, let's try creating an Interpol account, whereby let me clear data on my Interpol account. If an IP is poor, I cannot even access the registration of an Interpol account. So Interpol is a very good app for testing the quality of your IP. So let me go to apps, let me clear data on my Interpol because I had logged in with another account. So let me under storage, let me create data here. Create storage. Okay, once you clear storage like that, let's go back. Let's try creating another account here. So if, yeah, so you can say create an account, I can say another email here. Let me put that, click proceed. Atapol is very sensitive to poor IP. So if my IP was poor, I couldn't even have proceeded to this stage of being told to check my email to complete your login. I don't want to proceed to this one because I don't have a permanent number to verify my Atapol account, but this is the proof that this IP is high quality. In Atapol, if you're having a very bad proxy or using a VPN, during registration at this particular stage, they're going to tell you that you're using a VPN or proxy connection, kindly disconnect and continue using the app. So by the fact that I'm reaching on this page of Atapol, this tells you that the sx.org mobile proxies are good. Another thing, when you want to use sx.org proxies for Atapol, always use the mobile proxies. Let me talk further about that. Now, this is the thing I wanted to show you, that it can easily access Atapol and so many other restricted apps which are sensitive to poor IP or the sites that require strong proxies. So that one is a very good proof that this IP is good. You can see it has anonymity is 100%. It gives you a USA DNS. It gives you a very good ISP and so many other benefits from them. So check out sx.org. But before you go, let's just check the pricing. So let me log out first. Now this is the sx.org login page. So if you don't have an account, just come create an account and you can put your email and password and you're good to go. So let's go to their homepage. This is their homepage. And the homepage, they offer mobile proxies, they offer residential proxies, and they offer corporate proxy or data center. The mobile proxies pricing starts from $4.5 per GB, and they offer little devices and the best carriers mimicking little devices, and they have an unlimited bandwidth. Then the residential proxies, these are IP addresses from home internet networks. These are the home Wi-Fi networks. Working through these proxies is as close as possible to normal sessions. So this one is for ISP from little mobile devices. This one is from Wi-Fi devices. So if you're creating an Atapol account like the one I did earlier, like accessing the Atapol app like the one I did earlier, always use mobile proxies from sx.org because they offer little mobile devices with little ISPs. Yeah, so mobile proxies are the best. But residential proxies are also good depending on the type of sites you want to access. Corporate proxies are very good for sites which don't have a lot of security in terms of IPs. So that's it about the types of plans they have. Now, assuming now you have an account, you want to log in. So let's log into my account. So once you log into account, this is the dashboard. It shows you the number of traffic you have, the number of proxies you have online, have three proxies. Then they have the traffic consumption monitor. You can see the how you're using your traffic on your proxies. And also, if you have a new account, here, this option here, they will give you an option to link your sx.org with your Telegram account, whereby they are going to give you a promo code, which you're going to paste on that Telegram bot of theirs, and they're going to activate a free trial for your account. Can you get 1 to 3 GB on your account for testing? Then you can use that particular amount to test on your various sites. Then before you even go to the type of proxy, how to create proxies from from them. This is the top up page. For you to do any services here, you have to top up your balance, and the minimum top up is around $15. Yeah, and the support payment using cryptocurrency, USDT, yeah, and so many options. So just come here and check whether your payment option is supported. So once you top up your account, then you can come here to unlimited proxies options here, unlimited proxies. This for people who like reselling proxies. You can buy this proxies in bulk. They are sold in terms of proxies, and you can be able to resell to your people. For example, the cost of one is around $0.95 per month, but you can buy these ones and be reselling to people one at a time. Or they can also be used for companies which require use of many proxies in a day, in their various ways of working, in their whatever, in their line of work. Eh? So these one are for people who are heavy consumers of proxies. Then there is my proxies, whereby it's written here created proxies. This is now where you create a proxy for yourself now. For example, now you have loaded your balance here and you want a proxy and you don't want an immediate proxy. So just come here, created proxy, click create proxy here. Then you can name here like Curious Cat survey app, like that. Then here they tell you to select the type of proxies you need. For example, if you enable all this, it tells you that they're going to give you the best proxies from each and one of them. But if you select a particular one like this one, mobile proxy, they're only going to look for an IP for you, which is a mobile proxy with a cellular connection, with a real ISP. This one is residential proxy, home PC or Wi-Fi. Then these are corporate proxies. We call them data centers. So when you're creating a survey site, you want to log into a survey app or survey site, always use mobile proxies. They are the best because they have proxies from real devices with the real internet service providers or ISP. So come here and select mobile proxies country. You can select USA. You can select USA like that. Then here they show you regions with the large number of proxies or most popular among clients. So you can select most popular among clients. Then you can select any here. Let's try to select any state which has many proxies. Yeah. Then they even tell you to select it shows you the states or the cities with many proxies. So let's do Atlanta. Then another thing about them, they only allow you to select country, state or region, city, but they give you SSN is random. They are the one who they try to look for the best ASN or ISP, and they are allocated to you. So they don't give, for now they're not giving an option to select ISP, but I'm sure with the time they are going to enable that feature whereby you can be able to select the ISP you need. So once you reach the advanced settings page, now this is where you select the behavior of your proxy. The first option keeps you connected, meaning that when the IP goes offline, they give you the same IP from the same country, state, city, and ASN or ISP. Then the one is disconnect, whereby if you click this feature, when your IP goes offline, your connection is lost also. Then the rotation, most people are familiar with this one. You can check, you can set up your rotation time, 60 minutes, 120 minutes, whichever one you want. Your IP will be able to rotate after that particular time. Eh? But I like this first option here under sx.org. Then they have our authorization type, shared port, whereby you have to use a common server, but you have to log in using a username and password. Then they have dedicated port, where you incur an extra cost of 0.01 cents per day. But this one, it allows you to log in with the IP and port by whitelisting your IP here. Once you whitelist your IP here and select this option, and you can be able to log in using IP and port without the need of using a username and password. Also, you can set under this option, you can set the amount of traffic you want to use in a day or whichever period you need. But for now, I like using this option. Because remember, on crowd phones, they only require SOX 5 proxy with username and password. So once you do all those setups, create a proxy. And you're good to go. Now we have a live proxy. Yeah? Like that. So guys, that's all about sx.org. I have shown you the pricing, the cost of proxies from all their mobile proxies, residential proxies, and corporate proxies. I've showed you how to top up their balance. I've showed you how to access their free trial to test out their services. And I've shown you how to create a proxy for yourself. And also, you always use mobile proxies. For example, if you want to access Atapool. So guys, thank you for watching. Keep it locked to my YouTube channel.